Mention the words domestic violence, and the image that springs to mind for most of us is men abusing women.
But actually, reported domestic violence against men by women has more than doubled over the last 9 years.
Dom Littlewood's looking at this story for us.
Rightly or wrongly, we usually think of women as the victims of violence at the hands of men. But one in six men in the UK experienced some form of domestic abuse in their lifetime.
I was attacked with scissors, ashtrays. I was hit with a marble chopping board. I'd have cigarettes put out on me. I don't think there's any object in the house that at some stage wasn't used as a weapon. But for me personally, the biggest problem was the psychological and emotional violence.
Mark was with his abusive girlfriend for nearly 10 years. He's rebuilding his life now, so we've agreed to keep his identity hidden.
My relationship with her was like building a sandcastle on the beach, because every time you build a sandcastle, a wave would come along and smash it down, and that's what she did. Every time I built a little castle, she came and smashed it down.
Latest figures reveal that men in England and Wales aged between 20 and 24 are just as likely to be victims of domestic abuse as women in the same age group, but more and more of them are coming forward. So is that a sign that women are becoming more violent? Aggression expert Dr. Malcolm George believes, in fact, some women have always abused their male partners. Up until now, it's just been chronically underreported.
The problem with domestic violence, when you're talking about it female on male, is that it goes against the social stereotypes. When you talk about domestic violence male on female, you're going with the stereotypes. Everybody will believe you.
As a society, do we struggle to see men as victims of domestic violence?
Yes, because it goes against two taboos. The first taboo is that men don't want to be told they can be beaten up by women. But the other thing is that women don't want to hear that women can be violent, because that goes against notions of femininity.
Why are so many of these crimes unreported?
You get a whole series of reasons why men put up with it. They love the woman, they think she will change. Or if they do go and try and say, for instance, go to the police, they get such a negative reaction that convinces them they shouldn't confide in anybody.
For some domestic violence campaigners, this lack of understanding could have been easily avoided. Back in the early 1970s, Erin Pitsey started the first ever refuge for women fleeing from domestic violence. Now, this was a refuge for women only.
Women and children, yes, but I knew also, and almost immediately, men needed refuge, as well as women. But the trouble was I couldn't get the funding for the men's refuge. The whole subject had been hijacked by the feminist movement, and I could never get anyone to print the fact that men were also victims.
As Erin found in the 70s, attitudes don't change overnight, but things are improving. This place is unique. Now, I can't tell you where it is for obvious reasons, but I can tell you it's one of the first domestic violence safe houses opening up in Britain, solely dedicated to the caring of men. This one's not open yet. It's going to be about another week. It's been refurbished, but I can tell you it's already struggling to cope with demand for places.
We've only been up and running for a few weeks. We've got a couple of units open, and they're full. And I'm actually engaging with males over the phone every day now. Waiting, actually, to come into our refuges.
For one of the residents lucky enough to find shelter here, the refuge has provided him with an opportunity to start again.
I've had support and guidance and stability throughout since I have been here, and that is actually what keeps us victims going.
But it's society's lack of understanding that is still the biggest challenge for victims.
People will say to me, what was the biggest problem I faced? And I always come back to the same thing, it's belief. People believing that what you're telling them is true. I'd be attacked, and by the time the police would arrive, she'd be cowering in the corner, playing the victim role. And then you've got me in one corner who's quite animated, and the police look at that and see, you know, you're guilty straight away. They didn't have the experience. They took it at face value just all the time. And I was like hitting a brick wall.
Whilst it might seem positive that more men are coming forward, isn't there a danger of overstating the case?
If you look at the large body of research that's done in terms of domestic intimate relationships, there is a greater prevalence of women who say they have hit their male partner than women say they have been hit by their male partner.
After a long struggle, Mark finally found help and escaped the abusive relationship.
Do you think you're healed now?
Yeah. I've worked really hard to get my life back together, really hard. But I'm going to carry scars with me for the rest of my life.
Dr. Sarah Jarvis is here. So we don't know that there's more of it happening, but what we do know, more of it is being reported, which, so at least men are talking about.
That's got to be a good thing. I don't think there's that much more of it about necessarily, but obviously by definition, we don't know. What we do know is that maybe men feel a bit more comfortable talking about it, but maybe it's just that they know they're not the only ones, and that is so crucial in terms of getting them to come forward. Because the dreadful thing about domestic violence as a man, not only are you being beaten up, but you can't tell anybody. You can't tell your male friends.
Which is exactly what possibly women might be find it easier to do, to talk to their friends. As a man, I'm sure you understand that, Gillian.
I think there's a double problem, actually. I think one difficulty is that you are potentially a joke. Because the idea of the wife chasing you with a rolling pin is a kind of part of British comedy. But the other is that this very strong feminist agenda of the last 10 years has insisted that the violence is essentially from men to women, and you now have this coming change of law where women can have a premeditated murder of their partner and still claim manslaughter, whereas, of course, men can't. It's a very muddled situation.
OK, well, I think, I mean, it's a slightly different issue, but I think I understand it is men actually can. But it's, as you say, it's good that men can talk about it now. So I just wonder, how do you get to hear about it? It's not the kind of thing you go to your GP to discuss. How do you get to hear
about it? No, it's not. And I get to hear about it very often because somebody comes in with something else. So somebody will come in and it just seems that, you know, they can't be that clumsy. They can't have fallen down the stairs that often. That cigarette burn looks awfully like a cigarette burn. It doesn't look as if they fell over the cat and hit themselves. So often I'll talk to them about it, and because my antennae are up, because I'm wondering about it, suddenly there's this huge relief for them.
Yeah. I think what's so hard, though, is for all of us to understand the psychology of the abusive relationship, that you cannot get away. I mean, that's part of the film.
Very difficult. Yeah, there's lots more on our website, I believe, Sarah.
There is loads more on our website. It is bbc.co.uk/theoneshow. I was terribly worried about saying that bit, and Julian said he wouldn't help at all. He'd give me a glass of water and sympathy. Because I hate technology, but I've said it right. Everything you need to know is on there, and there's also an action line.
Okay.
That is a fear of technology, if you're frightened to read a web address out. That one. You should see a GP about that.
Julian's new film, The Young Victoria.